Snake. I've got something to tell you about Naomi Hunter.
What about her?
Is this conversation secure?
Don't worry, the monitor's off.
Okay.
What's up?
I was in the FBI too, you know.
I didn't know that. What's your point?
Dr. Hunter's story about her background, about her grandfather being an assistant secretary to Hoover in the FBI.
Yeah.
And then going undercover to investigate the mafia in New York.
Yeah, what about it?
It was all a big lie.
What did you say?
It was really bothering me. Why would she lie about it?
She lied.
She might be a spy.
Ridiculous.
Come on, even a high school student could see past it. The head of the FBI at that time, Edgar Hoover, he was a well-known racist. Didn't Naomi say that her father was Japanese?
Yeah.
Well, back then, there wasn't a single Asian investigator. Also, in the 1950s, the undercover mafia sting operations hadn't even started yet. They first started in 1960, in Chicago, not New York.
But...
you better check it out. The chief and the president mysteriously dying, and that ninja? Too many strange things are happening.
Are you saying that Naomi might be behind it?
I don't know. Either that, or she's working with the terrorists.
Could it be?
If I find out anything, I'll call. In the meantime, be careful.
Welcome, Cossack. This is the end of the road for you. Right, my friends? Listen, they agree. Ravens aren't scavengers like most people think. They're simply returning to the natural world, that which is no longer needed. Sometimes they even attack wounded foxes.
You were the one in the M1 tank? Must have been a tight fit for a big boy like you.
But that was no true battle. The Ravens and I were testing to see what kind of man you were. The judgment is decided. The Ravens say you are a true warrior.
Am I hallucinating? I can't move.
The Raven has put the mark of death upon you. Blood from the East flows within your veins. Your ancestors too were raised on the barren plains of Mongolia. Inuit and Japanese are cousins to each other. We share many ancestors, you and I.
I don't have any crows in my family tree.
You jest, but indeed ravens and snakes are not the best of friends. Nevertheless, you will make a worthy adversary. You live in Alaska too. You know of the World Eskimo Indian Olympics?
Yeah, I know it. Must be a real threat in the muck duck eating contest.
Yes, you are right. But there is another event that I excel at. It is called the ear pull. It is an event where two opponents pull each other's ears while enduring the harsh cold. It tests spiritual as well as physical strength.
You want to pull each other's ears?
The form is different, but the spirit is the same. Rejoice, Snake! Ours will be a glorious battle.
This isn't glorious. It's just plain killing. Violence isn't a sport.
Well, we'll see if there is iron in your words.
Thank you.
just as the boss said. It is my existence, which is no longer needed in this world. But my body will not remain in this place. My spirit and my flesh will become one with the ravens. In that way, I will return to Mother Earth who bore me. Snake! I will be watching you! Understand? Snake, take this security card. It will open that door.
Why?
You are a snake which was not created by nature. You and the boss, you are from another world. A world that I do not wish to know. Go and do battle with him. I will be watching from above. First, I'll give you a hint. The man who you saw die before your eyes.
What is it?
It was not the DARPA chief. It was Decoy Octopus, a member of Foxhound. He was a master of disguise. He copied his subjects down to the blood. So he drained the chief's blood and took it into himself. But he wasn't able to deceive the Angel of Death.
The Angel of Death? But why go to so much trouble? Why impersonate the Chief?
That is the end of my hint. You must solve the rest of the riddle yourself. Snake, in the natural world, there's no such thing as boundless slaughter. There's always an end to it. But you are different.
What are you trying to say?
The path you walk on has no end. Each step you take is paved with the corpses of your enemies. Their souls will haunt you forever. You shall have no peace. Hear me, Snake. My spirit will be watching you.
Snake, it's me.
Master.
It's about Naomi. Turn your monitor off.
What about Naomi?
Colonel, is Naomi there?
No, she's away. She's taking a short nap. So what is this about Naomi?
Okay, maybe we'd better let the Colonel hear this too.
Yeah, go on, Master.
Well, basically, Dr. Naomi Hunter is not Dr. Naomi Hunter at all.
What?
I thought her story of her background sounded kind of fishy, so I checked it out.
And?
There is an actual Dr. Naomi Hunter, or I should say, there was one. But she's not the woman we know. The real Naomi Hunter disappeared somewhere in the Middle East. Our Naomi must have somehow obtained her identification papers.
So then, who is she really?
She must be some kind of spy.
A spy?
Yes. Maybe she's been sent to sabotage this operation.
Are you saying she's with the terrorists?
I don't want to believe it either, but she is working for Foxhound.
So you think she had a part in the uprising?
Or she could be working with some different group altogether.
Different group? It couldn't be.
Place her under arrest.
What?
She's betrayed us. She needs to be arrested and interrogated to find out who she's with.
If she's one of their spies, then we're in big trouble.
What do you mean?
Nothing.
Have you let her in on some kind of vital secret or something? Does this have anything to do with the mysterious deaths of the DARPA chief and the Arms Tech president?
I have no idea.
Anyway, we cannot allow her to participate any further in this mission.
Wait a minute. Without her, we can't complete this mission.
I knew it. You're hiding something.
Give me some time. I'll try to get it out of her.
Hurry then. We've got to figure out who she is and what she's doing here.
I understand. Snake, give me some time.
I don't have any time left for you.
Thank you. Snake, it's me.
What's wrong? Did you find a good place to hide?
Yeah, thanks to the stealth gear. It looks like they've finished getting Metal Gear ready.
How do you know that?
I overheard them talking. Where are you now?
Right in front of Metal Gear, but it's strange.
What is?
There's nobody here. No guards, nobody patrolling. It's too quiet.
Maybe because they're all ready. They said they even input the PAL codes.
What should I do?
All we can do is use the override system that President Baker told you about.
But I've only got one of the three keys, and besides that, like Ocelot said, there's some trick to using the keys.
Leave it to me.
You got some kind of plan?
Well, I'm in the computer room right now. I'm trying to access Baker's private files.
Baker's files? Don't you need a password?
Of course, but there are ways.
Are you a hacker?
Yep, that describes me pretty well.
Does it look like you can get in?
I don't know yet. I'll give it a try.
I'm counting on you.
Snake, it's me again.
How's it going?
Not bad. I just got past his third security level. He was a pretty careful guy.
Do you think you'll break in soon?
I never met a system I couldn't bust into.
Okay, keep trying.
Snake, I did it!
You got past security?
Bingo!
Great. So what do you got?
I accessed the confidential Metal Gear file.
So what about the PAL override system that Baker talked about?
I haven't found it yet.
That's what I need to know.
But Snake, I found something else.
What?
The secret behind the new nuclear weapon. Just as I thought, the nuclear warhead is designed to be fired from the railgun like a projectile. It doesn't use fuel, so it isn't considered a missile. That way it can get around all sorts of international treaties.
Pretty sneaky.
Yes, but effective. And that's not even the scariest thing about this weapon.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this.
It's a stealth weapon.
You mean it won't show up on radar?
Yeah. The truth is, they've been working on a stealth missile since the late 70s.
Why weren't they able to develop one until now?
Because of the missile rocket propulsion system, it would be picked up by enemy satellites.
Oh yeah, that makes sense.
But unlike a missile, the railgun doesn't burn any propellant, so it can't be detected by any current ballistic missile detection systems.
An invisible nuclear warhead.
Totally impossible to intercept. And on top of that, it's got a surface-piercing warhead designed to penetrate hardened underground bases.
Yeah, we learned that lesson in the Gulf War.
This thing could mean the end of the world.
It's the ultimate weapon. And from a political point of view, it avoids the problem of nuclear reduction and nuclear inspections. Colonel, is this true? Are you listening?
I'm listening.
If word of this got out, it could delay the signing of the START 3 Treaty and cause a huge international incident.
Yeah, it would be nasty. The United States would be denounced by the UN. It could even bring the president down.
Did you know this, Colonel?
I'm sorry.
You've changed, Colonel.
I won't make any excuses.
Snake, new nuclear weapon. It's never actually been tested, only simulated.
You mean they ran a computer model?
Yeah, that's why they were conducting this exercise. They needed to get actual experimental data to back up the simulation.
What were the results of the exercise?
It looks like it went better than they hoped for, but I can't find the data anywhere on this network. You'd think that data as important as that would be carefully recorded.
It was. President Baker gave me an optical disc with all of the test data.
What? Do you still have it?
No. Ocelot took it from me.
The terrorists have replaced the dummy warhead with a real warhead. Once they input the detonation codes, they should be ready to launch.
So you think they can do it?
Well, the dummy warhead was designed to be identical to the real thing, so I think so.
Did you find out how to override it yet?
Not yet. It must be in a separate file. Right now I'm looking through all of Baker's personal files.
We're counting on you.
What's that? Get out of the way!
Snake!
Did you find it?
No. I haven't found out about the override system yet. But I found Baker's ulterior motive.
He's just looking to get rich, isn't he?
Well, that's part of it. Armstech is in much worse financial trouble than I thought.
I know they lost their bid to make the next generation fighter jet. That plus the reduction in SDI spending.
It looks like there was even some talk of a hostile takeover.
Everything was riding on this project, I guess.
And it looks like we were paying a lot of bribe money to the DARPA chief.
Bribe money, huh?
Yeah. And Baker was a big proponent of the nuclear deterrent theory.
I see. So anyway, what about the override?
Just give me a little bit longer.
Okay, I've entered the PAL codes and disengaged the safety device. We can launch anytime.
There's still no response from Washington. It looks like we'll have to show them that we mean business.
Should I set it for Chernerton, Russia?
No, there's been a change. The new target is Lopnor, China.
Why, boss?
I'm sure neither you nor Mr. Golukovich would really like to see a nuclear bomb dropped on your motherland, right?
Liquid. But why? There's nothing there.
Wrong. It's a nuclear test site.
A nuclear test site?
If we nuke a major population center, the game's over. But a nuclear explosion at a test site can still be concealed from the public. Meanwhile, Washington will be worried about the retaliatory strike from China.
That'll probably mean top secret talks between both countries' leaders.
Of course. And in the process, the president will be forced to divulge the existence of a new and highly destabilizing nuclear weapon to the Chinese. What do you think that will do to the US's reputation? Or the president's?
And with the CTBT, that means that China and India, I see.
Yes. When the other countries hear about this new weapon, they'll all want to contact us. Washington won't be very happy when we start selling their own system to the highest bidders. Yes, the president will break. He will give in to our demands.
Big Boss's DNA and $1 billion.
$1 billion?
That money will be used to cure our genome soldiers as well. I'm also including the Fox Dye vaccine in our demands.
Fox Dye. It killed Octopus and the Arms Tech president. So it's true that it affects older people first. Mantis might not have been affected because he wore a mask.
Wolf wasn't infected either. Perhaps due to those tranquilizers she always took.
Something to do with the adrenaline level in the blood. Or maybe it's just because this Fox Dye was still experimental and they haven't worked out all the bugs yet.
In any case, have you heard from your friend, Colonel Sergei Golukovich, at the Spetsnaz?
He still has doubts about the ability of Metal Gear. He said we can talk after Metal Gear's test launch is successful.
He's a very prudent man.
There's nothing to worry about. The Colonel wants Metal Gear and a new nuclear weapon so bad he can taste it. If Russia wants to regain its position as a military superpower, they need to reinforce their nuclear arsenal. They need a nuclear weapon that can't be intercepted. Metal Gear will allow them to gain first strike capability over the rest of the world.
Their regular army is in shambles, and they think they can restore their country's military power with nuclear weapons? Golukovich, he's no warrior. He's a politician.
Well, he's the one who gave us the Hind and most of our other heavy firepower.
He's got over 1,000 soldiers under his command. If we join forces, we could put up quite a resistance here. Since Mantis died, the genome soldiers' brainwashing has started to wear off. I'm worried about the men's morale. An alliance with the Russians would boost that as well.
What do you say?
We're not going anywhere. We're going to dig in here.
We can still escape.
We've got the most powerful weapon ever made, and we're about to ally with Golukovich's forces.
Are you going to fight the whole world?
And what's wrong with that? We can launch a nuclear warhead at any target on this planet. A nuclear warhead invisible to radar. And on top of that, this base is full of spare nuclear warheads. Once we get the DNA and the money, the world will be ours!
What about your promise to Colonel Golukovich?
I have no interest in the revival of Mother Russia.
You're not thinking of reviving Big Boss's dream.
From today, call this place Outer Heaven.
Big Boss's dream.
But Boss, you're not worried about the PAL being overridden. If the code is in it again, it'll be deactivated.
No need to worry. The DARPA chief and the Arms Tech president are both dead.
Does Snake know how the override system works?
You interrogated him, don't you know?
He didn't have any keys on him.
Good. Then no one can stop Metal Gear now.
By the way, what should we do with that woman? Want me to kill her?
Let her live. She's Campbell's niece, and Snake cares for her. We'll keep her as our ace in the hole.
Meryl, she's alive.
Snake, I found Baker's top secret files.
Great job.
How's it going there?
They've finished inputting the PAL codes. So how do we deactivate them?
Okay. You see, the override system that the president was talking about, it can also be used to input the detonation codes. You see, if you insert the keys when the warhead is active, you deactivate it. And if you insert them when it's inactive, it becomes activated. And you can only use the keys once.
Only once, huh?
Yeah. You better get started. We don't have much time.
But it takes 3 keys, right? I've only got one of them.
Hold on a minute. You see, that's the trick. You already have all 3 keys.
What are you talking about?
The card key is made of a shape memory alloy.
Shape memory alloy?
Yes. It's a material that changes shape at different temperatures. The key is made out of it.
This card key?
Yeah. The card key changes shape at different temperatures.
So this key is actually 3 keys in one. Clever.
Can you see the input terminals in the center of the control room?
I see them.
Those three laptop terminals are for the emergency input. There should be a symbol on each screen. Each symbol corresponds to a different key. Input the keys in order from left to right. The left one's for the room temperature key. See the symbol? Next to that goes the low temperature key. The one on the right is the high temperature key.
Okay, I got it. First, I change the shape of the card, and then I input them in order, right?
That's right. All you do is insert the card keys. After you insert the key into the module, a hard disk reads the information contained on it. Once you've finished with all three terminals, the code input process is complete. But here's the thing. You can only use the key three times. It's an emergency system. It's only meant to be used once.
The world is riding on that key, Snake.
Who's that? Damn! The key fell in the drainage ditch.
Snake! This is bulletproof glass. There's no way in. I'll enjoy watching you die.
Snake, you've got to get that key.
That takes care of PAL code number one. Now, PAL number two, freeze the key.
The box.